Hey guys, welcome to my first tutorial on how to create realistic lighting inside Blender using EEVEE. For this tutorial, I have already created the meshes before recording this video, so I will just demonstrate how to set the lighting for it. What we really need to do is to create the irradiance volume by pressing Shift A and then go to Light Probe tab, select the irradiance volume, then scale it up by pressing S on the keyboard. We need to cover the whole room with the inner box of the irradiance volume to get better results. You can use individual irradiance volume for the individual room. I'm just going to use two volume for this tutorial. As you can see, there are small yellow dots inside the volume. These are the sample of the irradiance volume, which can be increased inside the object data tab. You can increase the sample by changing the resolution, whether they are on X, Y or Z axis. But for this scene, I'm going to leave it as it is. Now what we really need is to create reflection cube map to capture reflection. So press Shift A and inside Light Probe, you can select reflection cube map. You can change the type of the reflection cube map inside the object data, but for this I'm going to use sphere reflection and scale it up to cover the whole scene. Now for the lighting, I will be using an HDR for the scene as it gives more natural colors. You can find it inside wall tab, select the background for the surface, and for color select environment. Now click on the folder and select the HDR map. You can use any HDR, but it depends on what you have desired for the scene. Rendered it out to see how it looks. For this video, I will increase the strength of the HDR to 5. And if you want to change the light that's coming from HDR from a different angle, you need a mapping node to the vector and then UV texture node to the vector again. In this way, you will be able to rotate the HDRs on Z axis. Now go under the render tab, change the bounce value for indirect light to 10 and click bake lighting. As you can see, it has already baked the lighting on the mesh, but it needs more depth. So for the depth, we will check screen space reflection and ambient occlusion. These will be available under the render tab. Play with the values to get the desired results. The icons that are shown under the indirect lighting tab, click on the icon to let it show the samples and cube map during real time. You can even change the size of them by changing the values. If you want to know how the irradiance volume is working, well, irradiance volume places samples throughout the scene and computes indirect lighting for them during baking. Now when it comes to render a dynamic object, like if I introduce an object inside the scene, then indirect lighting cache checks to see if it already has available light for the mesh, and if it has, then it will use it on them. Now I'm going to hide the samples and the cube map. Now we will be going to create the sunlight and press Shift A and go to the light tab and select sun. You can position and angle the light depending on what you want for the scene.
Now press the render button in the viewport to see how it looks. In the object data tab, I'm going to change the color of the light matching the sunlight, and also be increasing the value of the contact shadow distance so that the light of the sun doesn't bleed from the edges of this room. You may also increase the value of the clip, and that's under the shadow tab. Now go to the render tab and check the feature bloom. You can play with the threshold and the values underneath it, and what looks best for the picture, go for it. We just need to rebake the indirect light for the sun indirect lighting. To hide the exterior picture of the HDR, we need a sphere. So we will be going to introduce a sphere in this scene so that it blocks the outer exterior picture of the HDR. So press Shift A and then select mesh and then select the sphere. Then press tab so you can enter into the edit mode. Then press Shift N and in the normal consist check inside. Now scale it up and then apply emissive material on it with slightly blue color with an increasing strength. Now we need a cube to set a volumetric light. Press Shift A, now go to the mesh and select cube and scale it up so that it covers the whole room. Go to the material and material tab, remove it from the surface, and under the volume tab select scatter volume. Now go to the render tab and check the volumetric. Now render the scene and change the density side by side by proving the render. Now go to the scene tab under color management tab, change the look base contrast to very high and exposure to 1 and gamma 2.5. Change the contrast as what looks best for the picture, what you have desired for the scene. Color management can completely change the look of your render, so try to change it while after you are done with the lights and materials. Now I think it's done. If you like my tutorial, follow me on Patreon where you will be able to get the project files which I will use in my tutorials. Thanks for watching.